Wrestling.
And that's the intro to this series. We decided. Do we do plugs?
Yeah, we can do plugs. I got a new book. You can catch a link in the description. Hit the like button and comment at the same time. Very handy. Subscribe if you haven't already.
It's really most important that you do both. You don't have to do them simultaneously. That's challenging, I understand.
No, open the app on your phone. Type your comment.
And then hit enter and like at the same time?
Hit send and like at the same
and
time.
And that's yeah. Two views. Man, that's big brain right there.
Honestly, we appreciate each and every one of you. This is by far our most popular series, so we're all glad to have you here. I have a Patreon. If you're interested in providing me monetary compensation at the absolute minimum rate of $1 a month, if you did, you'd be cool like Rob and a guy from Ohio.
Yep. Who are both very cool people.
Yes. All that being said, did you have any like major projects you wanted to plug?
I don't do projects. I'm just your co-host.
Starting a new clothing line or some sort of brand deal with Chef Boyardee?
Could you imagine how boring my clothing line would be? I got new merch out. It's just a plain black t-shirt, but I'm selling it.
So cloak brand?
Ah! Oh! Ho, 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 ho. Ooh! Ow! Ooh, that stung! That hurt!
All right. I love Markiplier. I do. And some of his clothings, they look pretty neat. But a lot of them are just a regular-ass t-shirt with cloak written on it somewhere. Moving swiftly along.
We are doing the wrestlings.
We are. And boy howdy, do we have some stuff to catch up on. It has been a while since we recorded, as always, as is tradition.
These take a while. We have other projects. And
oh, the last 2 weeks were just crazy hectic.
Very busy.
Yeah,
so
incredibly.
Hopefully we will be catching up, but that is always the hope, and hope springs eternal for a reason.
Yes. So I have started adding a recap portion to my notes, and I will share that with you. What happened last time? Dan Severn beat The Rock to retain the WWF Championship and tried to leave our company.
Rude.
Chris Jericho beat Edge for the Intercontinental title. HBK beat The Patriot in a steel cage match to end their feud. The Hardys beat the Golden Age of Grotesque for the tag titles to end the feud and just solidify the Hardys as champs. Homewreckers Inc. and the Aranese are continuing to fight. Sho Funaki beat China to retain the European Championship, although I think their feud is still going.
Mm-hmm.
Christian somehow managed to piss off Kane, so they're fighting now. Paul Ellering now manages Mark Henry and Pierre Houllet, and Brother Love now manages Bradshaw and Test. I am surprised that in 1999 the Brother Love gimmick is still over.
But it is.
Well, not over, but fans enjoy it.
They're not tired of it, and somehow Road Dogg is still over. And once Road Dogg is no longer over, we will make some changes to Road Dogg's career.
Yeah, we were also talking about breaking up slash trimming the GOG and or the Brood.
Because they're half our roster.
they are, and that does make things a little difficult. We could use a face manager, maybe. We could maybe eventually do a roster split.
We have enough main eventers that we could easily pull that off.
Yeah.
But we would need more lower card guys for that.
So first
and they're
first.
Expensive, so we have a huge roster size available to us.
Oh yes.
So we're are we going shopping, as it were?
Well, not fully shopping. There's one person in particular I am looking for. My keyboard is weird, hold on. There it is. Nope, she's not there. There she is.
She's with Extreme Championship Wrestling. She went to ECW. Oh, she's good.
She started in ECW. Yeah, she's good. What the fuck?
Man, the person who made this scenario sometimes makes very weird decisions. I can never know.
Very cynical decisions, I would say. Let's look, 49%, that's not. Let's negotiate. Okay, what's your offer? 300, man. What do you think? Better put some ice cream bars on that offer. Lita, you canonically, in real life, got ice cream bars. So, a little bit more. Nice.
And, yeah. Send it right to the right officer. All right.
All right. Next month, we'll get her.
Nice.
Okay. So, let's view our own roster again here. Well, no, let's go to the book, because
it's easier to see the roster as they're laying.
Moreover, I want to see faction breakup options. So we can have one where they're kicked out. Oh, lowercase t. Adding, we don't need to do that. Merging, we don't need to do that. Splitting the faction, I think that just breaks them up entirely.
If we decide to split
it splits them into two factions. Yeah.
I would suggest we split the Hardys from the rest of the brood.
Well, the Hardys are still attacked.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. Split them off from Edge and Christian.
Okay, and then Gangrel's still with Edge and Christian?
Yeah, like, make it the brood, and then have the Hardys split off into their own thing. Make them proper faces.
So, I think remove faction members, either kicked out or time to leave. Was there one that where they... No, there's not one where they just leave. So, I think time to leave is a little bit more like...
Yeah, like, one guy is bouncing, as it were.
Let's see if we can do it with a tag team. Well, I suppose we have to pick a faction, though.
Yeah.
The brood... Time to leave. Select member.
Is one member.
It is one member. Oh, no, there's an add button. So Matt Hardy and Jeff Hardy.
As opposed to split faction?
Split faction would create two different factions.
And we don't want to bother creating a faction with Matt and Jeff Hardy?
No, because they're already a tag team.
Yeah, okay. That makes sense then.
All right, so let's book that. That'll be interesting.
Just... Like, that's... Look how many people that is.
It's a lot.
It's all good people.
It's the same situation for Golden Age Grotesque, except one of those guys isn't working right now. So it's literally just Mankind, Goldust, and Mark Mero.
Yeah, they're fine because it's still a trio.
Yeah, that's not bad.
They happen to be a big section of our face main event, but, like, that's okay.
Well, and the fun thing is when we book... them in, like, an angle or a gimmick where he's the team...
Vader gets over also, which is nice.
Yeah. We'll get to use him sometime in the year 2001 at this point, I think.
Yeah.
So let's get into booking. Let's actually do some shit.
We already did the pregame last time at the end of the session where we made sure all the manager people were doing stuff.
I'll go back to the dashboard and show you guys. We're having Pedro Jackson reassure Mark Mero. Hopefully they do a good job with that because Mark is... He gets moody when he loses.
He's perpetually kind of sad.
We're prepping Kurt Hennig to come in. We are recruiting Ultimo Dragon. And finalizing deals for Lita and Chris Canyon. So, of course, Undertaker will be coming back in a month or two, and Vader is out for a while.
Nice.
Training facility upgrades available. Did we already do that?
I believe we did, but it certainly doesn't hurt to check.
Yeah.
We did, yes.
Or wait, yeah.
Yeah, it's level 2. Excuse me. All right. So.
Okay, so,
Let's book our card. Let's get the existing feuds on the card first.
Yes.
Because we've got a bunch that are still going.
We do. We've got the Prove Yourself between the Homewreckers and the Aranies.
Another month of promos on this can get this up into the 200s easy.
Yeah, sure.
Shit, today's promo, Mike.
Yeah. Let's work something a little bit.
Yeah, they're well past the point where it would be good to use them to grind other stuff.
Masked Attacker's not bad.
There's no need for them to do a contract signing. It doesn't make any sense.
Yeah, we don't need to blow anything off either. Unlikely Partners, we haven't held with them.
Let's just have them beat up on 4 local talents?
Yeah, I mean, it doesn't actually do anything.
Do it!
Alright, cool. Let's grind that up a bit. Just keep the feud alive. Okay. Then we've got... This has got a lot of staleness, so I'd suggest a promo here. Rockin' Dan Severn.
I feel like this can just be... It's not over. It's not got the orange arrows.
Mm-hmm.
So I'd say either have them fight or have them do a promo battle.
I'm going to go promo battle because they're great.
Yeah, it's better for the feud.
So that'll be probably our pre-main event. Chris Jericho versus Edge. Wow, look at all that staleness.
That can be a match.
Yeah.
That could even be... A tag match or some multi-person match.
That's exactly what I was thinking.
This is the one where we wanted to blow it off in a feud, in a promo eventually, once it's at max staleness, because we want Chris Jericho to keep the championship, but we want Edge to go over.
Okay. Yeah, alright.
If memory serves.
I like your idea there. Keep that in mind, because I might forget. So let's go to... Well, let's finish off with our promos here. China versus Funaki is nearing the staleness, so let's get a promo in on that.
Try and get it over the top. Yeah.
They can fight.
Yeah, because we're trying to get them over.
Yes. And I think Kane and Christian's fine. That could be a match. Yeah, and Jericho Dish. So, let's go to tag team. Let's go to 2v2. Let's get... Edge is easy because he's with Christian.
Edge and Christian versus...
God, our main event is huge. It's beautiful.
Kane and...
Oh, yeah, because Kane and Christian. That's right. Good thinking. Brilliant thinking. Chris Jericho.
Who's Edge fighting again? Chris Jericho. And it's a good fate. It's neutrals versus heels. It works. All right.
This could be our main event.
Yeah, we'll leave it there for now. If something better pops up...
I mean, we've got a whole bunch of wrestlers to use that aren't in feuds and stuff, so...
Yeah. And we have other shit we need to do. We have, like, other feuds. We titles that don't have a feud right now, it feels like. Mm-hmm.
The other thing we wanted to...
And that's all our feuds taken care of.
Was that all our feuds? Was there one more?
Yeah.
Oh, that was a potential feud. Okay, that's why I got confused.
Yeah, so that's all our feuds. So Dan needs a new challenger, I believe, because him versus The Rock is over.
No.
Oh, no, it's still going. Well, then, I'm dumb. Is there a title that doesn't have a feud?
Tag titles.
So who are our next tag team contenders?
Are the Hardy Boys still neutral?
I believe they would be, and they're splitting
Matt
off.
Neutral, Jeff.
We could use this as an opportunity to turn them face, put them up against some proper heels. They're splitting off.
How is our heels in terms of tag teams? I don't think they're very strong. I guess DX, but we just moved past DX being in the title scene.
Could be a different configuration of DX. We could also use this as an opportunity to turn them heel.
True.
They're leaving the Brood, who are a neutral faction, but we are also building up the Aranese, who are heels, to be future contenders. We could also leave the Hardy Boys neutral.
I think keeping them as a pivot is not a terrible idea.
I don't think so either, really.
We do have a lot of face teams. Honestly.
So, I'd say, yeah, let's leave them as a pivot.
In that case, let's just get a good match in there. It doesn't have to be a feud.
Well, I mean, if they're going to lose the feud, why not make it a feud? That's a great way of boosting up El Samurai and Jushin Liger.
Well, then it's more a great way of boosting up Matt and Jeff Hardy.
Yeah.
And the tag titles for that matter.
Yeah.
Okay. Booked.
Not for the title.
Not for the title.
They haven't had them long enough.
Okay. We've got two left that we can do.
Let's get some of our actual main eventers on the card.
Did we want to make this a feud and keep it up? I mean, it'd be
we can. We
hot.
Can do it for free.
Sure. Add feud.
Neither one of those guys has a one star in anything, right?
God, no. That's why we hired them.
Yeah, so then, yeah, let's make it a feud. It could just be, honestly, new challenger, anything. These guys are all hot. This is a transitional feud. The Hardys are going to win it. Unless it gets super over and goes for a long time.
This is a very important feud.
Yeah, the game can't tell what we write there.
Okay, so we've got that. Now we've got a bunch of main eventers that are not doing anything.
Yeah, they're just not doing it. Do we want to make... We have such a huge main event. Do we want to make another main event feud that isn't for the title, like in the vein of Shawn Michaels versus the Patriot? Are there just two main eventers who are super over who we could have fight? Mick Foley, Ken Shamrock. Owen Hart, who's a face, I think. Ken Shamrock. Stone Cold versus Triple H, although that'd be mostly promos.
Alright. And with that idea of mostly promos, Mick Foley and Goldust against Shawn Michaels and Triple H. That's going to get four of our hottest people in shows in a feud.
And Triple H's weekly sloth isn't that much of a hurt if we want to have them have a match.
Sure, yeah.
Yeah, let's do that. Let's book it.
Okay. Mick Foley and Goldust versus Shawn Michaels and... Triple H. Alright, we'll book that in a match. We'll see how bad his sloth is for this situation.
And we can always move it to mostly promos if it needs to.
Yeah,
be.
We can definitely
so,
do that.
So, let's make it a feud. What are they mad about? What do they hate? Why are they...
I booked that as a single.
Oh, whoopsie.
Sean, Triple H, Mick Foley, Goldust.
Book.
And here we go. Why are they hating? Add feud. Nothing really open. Disrespect is kind of built in DX shit.
Yeah, the DX were assholes to them is perfectly reasonable.
And this is already gold, so I'd say
let's build that up.
Disrespect. Oh, can't be created with temporary teams. Okay, well, they're in stables together.
Game. All right, you know what? No. Scroll down to the fill-in feud. Type disrespect. Let's use it.
But just as feuds cannot be created with temporary teams.
But they're in stables.
Hold on. Let's see if I can do this the costly way. Feud add factions, Generation X, Golden Age Grotesque.
Okay. All right.
That gives us a lot of stuff to pivot around too.
Yeah, it does. It's more wide varied.
Okay.
Disrespect?
Yeah, disrespect. Unless there was a good like stable only thing. Let's check that. End of the line disband faction.
If we were planning on disbanding either the Golden Age of Grotesque or DX, two factions fight to put an end to each other is inherently hype, and that is a great way to do it.
I think I'm fine with that. You know, whichever one we decide at the end of this, I think that's really fun, and I want to build up this option.
Yeah, that's really cool. Let's do it.
All right, cool. I'm glad we did this. All right, I'm going to redo this match just in case.
Yeah, delete, because it won't recognize it otherwise.
Who knows? Yeah, tag team.
2v2. Shawn Michaels, Triple H, Goldust, and McFarlane. Go.
And that's got into line.
Yeah, cool.
All right.
There's just not enough room for both of us at the top of the card.
So, man, we've got so many good wrestlers. This is why the faction split is so tempting.
We've only got the one spot left. We've got all our promos for... We got all our feuds for all our titles and all the extra feuds we put in. So this is just a highlight spot. Who's a really good worker who could use a highlight?
I'm going to say let's stick in the main event, okay? Because we do have, first
just
of all...
Just to make the show better?
Yeah, and we've got doubled up on the Brood and the Hardy Boys.
Yeah, let's have...
Ken Shamrock, Owen Hart? I think it'd be a good match.
Sure, you could throw The Rock in there if you wanted. You don't want more than four people in a match, because after that, the crowd starts to get upset.
The Rock is doing stuff with Dan, but we could do the Patriot.
Yeah, he just came off a feud.
Yeah, so, Patriot, Owen, Shamrock.
Go.
Booked.
That goes higher up the card.
Yeah.
That's fine. Yeah, that's good.
Yeah, that'll work.
All right.
Wow, what a card.
That's a good way of starting the King of the Ring.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, I forgot we're building the King of the Ring.
So, speaking of, I want this... I want to do the King of the Ring tournament, but...
It's all done at once?
Yeah, it's all done at once at the pay-per-view.
Before
otherwise,
the pay-per-view.
We can... Otherwise, we'd have to work it in. I like that. I want to highlight that because I remember it from last year. I like that about this game.
Yeah.
I don't have to take up half my card during the whole pay-per-view cycle.
Yeah. All right, let's play this.
Yeah. Who are we going for King of the Ring, though?
Oh, who knows, man. Probably a bunch of people that we didn't get a... Wow!
Oh, this is gonna be a good feud!
All right, awesome. So here's my thinking. This is non-title.
China versus Sho Funaki was Sho Funaki going, like, what a woman!
Basically, yeah.
Perfect.
I'm thinking El Samurai and Justin Liger get over.
Oh, yeah, you gotta establish
it. Yeah. And that's part of why there's the fight, the tension between the Hardys and Edge.
Because it happens right after.
Yes.
Because, like, the Hardys come back from their loss, and they get shit from the rest of the Brood, and you're like, you know what? Fuck you guys. We don't need you.
Yeah, didn't you just lose your title to Jericho?
Yeah, at least I have a title. Hey! Hey!
Yeah. All right. Wow, a great match. Cool spots. Very important feud. Good times. All right, that was hurt a
90%
little bit.
Effective. It was only hurt by being something we don't use.
Lower star rating.
Yeah.
They lost a little popularity. The Brood took a hit there.
Yeah, because they lost...
Two major
They lost the Hardy Boys, the tag champions.
All right, let's continue on. This match looks good. Who needs the win more? Shamrock is not the best there. Owen's fine. His morale's a little low.
Shamrock's the only one who's not over.
Yeah.
But Owen's morale is low.
We could take a risk to get Shamrock over, or we could up Owen's morale.
Either one's fine. Both have pluses and minuses.
We
just turned Shamrock heel, so getting him wins makes him more established. Owen is one of our top guys and is already super over.
Yeah, I guess we could probably get Owen a win next week and get that morale boosted.
Either one is fine.
I think Ken. Let's give it a shot with Ken.
They liked that.
Nice. They liked it. They liked it just fine.
And Owen wasn't too upset.
No, no. Well, it is, yeah. Okay.
Yeah, of course. As ever. Of course. Yeah, hot segment. Hot segment. Perfect. Yes. Yeah, all right, great.
Bless you, lovely children.
Great.
All right, end of the line feud is beginning. Let's see, whose morale is lower? Oh, these guys, definitely. So let's give them the win.
Yep. Well, I don't know how we're ending this, but either DX or the Golden Age of Grotesque is ending at the end of this, mm-hmm. So...
It's okay.
It started out at 117. It did a little better than okay.
No, I mean the star rating. Yeah, that you pay attention to this shit, and I pay attention to this shit, and that between the two of us, we get shit done.
It started out at 117.
Oh, I didn't notice Ivory's intense biker gimmick is marked out now. That's awesome.
Yeah, good.
Sweet, sweet.
This feud started out over 100.
Yeah, dude. Well, these are all really hot
properties.
Oh,
that's going to be good.
Fantastic.
Nice, nice.
Loving that. Feud's hot now.
Good. That's what I wanted.
Mm-hmm. All right, continuing on. And this big match here, I would say Kane and Chris Jericho go over. Further frustrating Edge and Christian.
Okay, sure.
But they got that morale's lower, and their overness, the overness of Edge and Christian's lower. They took a hit.
That's up to you.
I think... to make up for the faction popularity loss, we should probably have Edge and Christian go over here.
Also, Christian, Edge just lost.
Yeah.
And Christian's whole gimmick is like, he keeps weaseling wins out from under Kane's nose.
Sure. All right, let's do that. 4 stars, not bad. Oh, the greatest wrestler feud's hot. Cool. Nobody got injured. That's what I love to see.
Yeah, nobody broke all their legs. That's always good. All
right, and what did we get for that? 68 points. 4.5-star event. Fantastic.
Okay.
Good job, us. Let's meet Pat myself.
Let's see how much
back.
We destroyed them. Oh, Lord.
As usual.
We got 10 times. Dude. EPW. That's Eastern Pro Wrestling, I believe is what they
I believe so, yeah. That's Arn Anderson's Fed.
He's going to show up outside our house with a flaming trash can.
At his clock.
He's got the blicky on him at all times, okay?
Alright, they're doing well. I wish they were more competition. We need an AEW is what we need.
These are our feeder feds, man.
I guess. I just throw money at Lita and Chris Canyon and move on with my life.
Give me these.
We were using those. Gim.
Gim.
All right, cool. We got more staleness out of the Rock and Dan Severn.
That's what you wanted,
uh-huh.
Yeah.
Wow, Under the Line started with 5 staleness. That's hot.
Yeah, bro.
Chris Jericho and Edge, that bumped up in staleness too. China and Funaki, still pretty low, so we should keep them to promos.
Yeah.
Kane and Christian's doing okay. Maybe a promo this week, and that's
just starting,
so we're fine there. So, Aaron Ease and Homewreckers Inc. Let's get a feud thing. Let's see if there's one we can boost. I don't think either of them are too serious that we can't do silly ones. Not a car destruction. We've already done so many car destructions.
Of course. To be fair, it is kind of Homewreckers Inc.'s thing. Destroying cars at homes.
Yes, that's true. Maybe for like the one of the go home.
Yeah.
Yeah. Smack Talk. This just seems.
Two participants. Okay.
Yeah, they count as two because they're two.
Yeah, that's. Okay, this is different from a promo battle.
Yeah, that's.
Somehow. Okay, whatever, man.
I forget how. I remember it is different, though.
We'll find out.
We will find out again, yeah. All right, so let's.
Promo up our high staleness feuds.
Yes, that is what I want to do. So China versus Sho Funaki. More hype for the feud, maybe get a little bit more staleness, just use a promo battle.
Yeah, that's a good idea.
Then we've got, that was the worst of them, but let's do a promo here this week for Kane and Christian.
Okay.
Just to be on the same side.
And also to get it a good, varied balance.
Christian needs the overness, I think.
Yeah.
So, let's do that.
And also, Kane can beat him up.
Yeah. All right. So, End of the line needs to continue.
It's got plenty of staleness, but I don't know that we need to have another match immediately. But we've got a lot of promos on this card already.
We do. So let's book other things and see what we're left with, okay? Jushin Thunder Liger and El Samurai versus the Hardy Boys. I'm sure the rest of that says. Yep.
Yep.
Another match with them, you think? How do we want to roll that?
Is there a way we could freshen that up somehow so it's not just them doing tag matches for 4 weeks? If not, I mean, that can just be the thing. Is they're just doing like a best of five series.
Ooh, I like that.
Then let's do that.
All right. That's what VIF stands for. Five is five.
Not for the tag.
So they lost, the Hardy Boys did last week, so maybe they should win this
week. They should win this week.
Put them. Okay. Then we've got. We go to singles. Rock and Dan Severn. I feel like we could do another tag match.
Oh, this is straight up tag match in booking. The face team versus the heel team works. And fucking Rockin' Dan Severn versus Jericho and Edge also works. Either one is fine. We probably shouldn't do both.
Rockin' Edge versus Jericho and Dan Severn. Could you imagine?
God, that would be so good. That's what the main event.
Yeah. Okay.
All right, what do we got for feuds that haven't been booked yet?
Okay, there's...
China and Shofunaki, is that on there? Yeah.
Yes, it's a promo. And then... It's the... the DX Golden Age is what's left.
Yeah. So, since it's DX versus the Golden Age, we could do a big six-man tag?
Sure, we could.
And have... Because who won last week?
Golden Age, I think, because they're more out of the way.
Okay. Then we do a big six-man tag with Sean... And by the way, Triple H didn't hurt that match that much.
No, not too bad. But let's
China
some...
is in a match. Is that...
She is. You're absolutely right. Billy
well,
Gunn
she's in a promo.
Still, this is fine. But Billy Gunn could
X-Pac and
match.
Shawn Michaels.
Yeah, and DX is winning this, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, so Billy Gunn could use a morale boost. He's kind of not been doing well. Same with X-Pac. Might get him over a little
and
bit.
And then just the boys.
Versus the boys. Gold Dust, Mrs. Foley's baby boy, and Mark Mero.
Mark Mero's going to be sad, but...
Yeah, he will, but you know, it is what it is, my friend. Okay, this should be there. That can move there.
And then I think promos for the rest of this pay-per-view cycle for that, if we can.
Maybe, yeah. That sounds good.
It's got plenty of staleness, so we don't have to, but just it's a great way to get the feud hyped.
Sure, and they're all very charismatic, but and we can use Triple H.
This feud is already hyped, is the thing.
Okay, so let's do something with some of our lower card guys. You know, we complain about not having a lot of heel tag teams. Part of the problem with that is that Mosh and Thrasher suck. They're not over. We could do a heat promo for them.
I forgot that they were on our roster. Genuinely forgot they were there.
For being fucking main eventers, like in that, or maybe high mid card, for being as high as they are, they're not very over at all. So we could do a heat promo here. It's a bit of a risk.
It's the one work rate that's doing it.
Yeah. And,
then let's do another match or another promo. We got plenty of matches on this card, so... We could use another match if we wanted to keep it 50-50.
It's that 50-50 booking. Everyone hates that, though. let's see. Let's get some good wrestlers up here.
So, Eddie Guerrero.
Oh my god,
Kurt
I forgot
Angle.
We have Kurt Angle. And Eddie.
Yeah, Eddie Guerrero versus Kurt Angle.
I don't think Kurt's debuted yet.
So
get out of here.
Someone had a different idea.
Debut Kurt Angle.
Type debut into the search bar and save yourself some time.
A butt. Start the show off hot.
Then put him in a match right away with established talent, have him beat him. Easy clap.
Eddie's hot.
Yeah, easy clap.
Yeah.
Done.
Eddie's heel, right? Yeah, perfect.
Done and done. And that's the show.
That's the show. All right. Hoosah. Hey, it's Kurt Angle, everyone. Wow, they don't care.
Debuts, fucking Bronze Star.
That too. That's fine. Kurt Angle's here. He's going to beat Eddie Guerrero, despite the hotness. Good match.
Yeah.
Good match.
There we go.
Another hot segment. Beautiful. So this is the Hardy Boys going over.
Hey, that got over. Got more stillness.
Oh, good. Right, Hardy Boys going over.
If we're doing like a best of series,
yeah. That's right. Nice, looking good.
Only got a 2 hype, so promo I think would help for that.
Yeah, it might. Brawl in a drunken alley.
Good.
I don't know how the alley got drunk, but it did.
It's a dark alley. But...
Shut up. DX is winning this.
That's the plan.
Yeah. Crowd is interested. It became hot.
Of course it did.
Gold Dust work rate increased level 3.
Oh, finally! Oh my god, he's 4-4 right now.
Yeah, because he's fucking Gold Dust, man. this shit is happening. Aaron Hayes.
Yeah, Aaron Hayes. They're the ones who need it.
Oh yeah, this is the Smack Talk thing.
Yeah. So they come off the better.
Cool. I don't know why. Okay. Hot segment. Gorgeous.
It's another thing to do besides promo.
Yeah, I agree. So this one is...
We didn't pregame who wins this. But
we
that's
did not.
Two champs versus their two challengers.
Yeah, I think the champs should win for their morale as well.
Okay.
Stop and start action. Wasn't the greatest
match.
They didn't
like that.
It was random die roll is what it was. That took a whole... We would have been a 4-star match at least.
Well, they're all winners, whatever.
No, yeah, it's still 4 stars. Okay, 57 points. Still an amazing show. All right, did anybody get fans?
Just us. We're becoming that which we sought to destroy.
Just a message about the work rate.
Good.
Is everyone still not happy? Oh, no, for the offer.
He'll get happy.
He'll get over it. He's the champ. Alright, so, we said this week let's do so many feuds, promo for this. I want to increase hype for the feud, so I think just a promo battle.
Yeah. It's at that stage where we use our stuff that's already built.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Do we have anything else that is getting up there? Well, these guys are usually good. Let's build something with them.
$243. I just realized how over this is.
Right. No, it doesn't look like we've got anything crazy down there. We could try a silly thing and see how it goes. A slime surprise, a push-up contest.
I like slime surprise because it's got traditional usage within Homewreckers Inc. They slime surprise the Irenes.
They do. That's their big move. All right. Does anything... We talked about doing a promo for... Let's do that exact one.
Yeah. Because it could use more stamina.
Yeah. So let's try to hype it up some more again. That's two promo battles, though.
So? We can repeat them?
Yeah, I know.
It works. All right. So the reason I want to do this is give them more stamina, but if they don't get any more stamina, we blow this off at the pay-per-view.
Oh, definitely. The other one we were talking about was the
Kane versus,
end of the line.
Yeah, end of the line is fine. It's got plenty of stainless, but and it's 135. It got over. It worked.
Yeah.
But Hurt My Ego could use some more red arrows.
More red arrows there. Let's give him some red arrows. I'm just gonna have another promo battle. It's the most red arrows.
It is. We'll see. This can work as an experiment. If the game doesn't like it,
I mean,
right?
It's repeatable.
I don't always trust the game when they say things. So, there we go. Now, let's do matches for the rest of the card.
You sure do? You want to try and give another shot?
No. I know what we were told by our inside source on information on this game, but I don't trust it, so...
Okay, so Rockin' Dan Severn is still going.
We don't want to give away... This is one of those ones where I don't want to give the singles match away on free TV if we can avoid it.
No, I would agree with that. Oh, we have 5 segments left. We might be able to book them in a...
In a promo, we'll see. Yeah. I know I said we kind of wanted to not do many more matches for DX versus Golden Age of Grotesque, but it's over and it's doing well, and this is the kind of feud where them fighting a lot works. Where the two...
The factions going...
Two factions just absolutely coming to blows, battering the shit out of each other for survival. It works.
Okay. So that's the one. Oh, no, we want, like, two.
Well, yeah, we did a big six-man last week. Let's have a 2v2 match with a combination we haven't seen before if we can.
Well, we've only got the 3 in the gold match.
So, Mark Merrill and Mankind, then.
Yeah. Do we want them to win? Look at his poor morale.
Sure.
Yeah, fully so.
Yeah.
Ooh, if they're going to win, let's make it Goldust.
Okay.
Because, look, Foley's 92 morale, Goldust 73.
There you go. All right.
Against...
What's a combination of DX we haven't seen before?
Completely...
China could be in this. She's not in a match.
True. And her morale's really high, so that's fine. We haven't been using Road Dog because of the sloth, but he doesn't need the hits and morale.
Sean?
Okay, Sean's not a bad
China guy. And Sean?
Yeah.
There you go.
Okay, put that up here a little bit. Oh, that's not cute. That might end up being our main event if we promo the...
Yeah, if we promo that.
Okay, so...
What does that leave us with feuds-wise?
Rock and Dan Severn, Jericho and Edge.
And we just had them do a tag match last week.
Yeah.
So if it ends up being that they have to do the actual thing, like the singles matches, then it has to be that. I want them on the card.
I want to see if this works with Jericho and Edge.
Okay. What are we doing?
Chris Jericho, Edge, and Eddie Guerrero. Wow, Kurt Angle did shoot up pretty fast.
yeah,
fucking making a critical four. It did work.
Nice, yeah, just get some of the guys in the mix.
Yeah.
And then do the same thing with the Rock and Dan Severn.
Okay.
Just call it, like a preview of the people you'll see in the King of the Ring.
Sure, that's a great idea.
So then we can have the Rock, Dan Severn, and then two other main eventers who aren't busy.
Yeah, fantastic. Great reason to get Stone Cold.
Yes, that's what I was thinking.
Patriot. Oh, no, because of the... Where are Dan?
And then...
The Rock.
And then, do we want to do another Fatal 4-Way? We could. We could just keep it to a triple threat. Everybody else is kind of busy, actually.
Yeah, or not...
Owen Hart.
Owen hasn't been in there in a while. That's true.
And we were thinking about getting him a win. But we ended up getting... Did we end up having the other person win there?
I think we did Shamrock to try to put him over.
So, remove title. So, Owen could fucking win this.
Yeah. That could be a really big thing for Owen. That'd be cool. I think everybody else... We'll check the morale when we get there.
But yeah.
Okay. So, now we do have space.
So, we can make other promos and shit. Or add other matches. Because we've got all our promos... All our feuds covered.
I'm a looking here. Seeing what our options are.
Manager promo for maybe Mark Henry and Pierre Roulet?
Yeah, we could do that. Well, I think it just is for one wrestler.
Then for Mark Henry?
Yeah, and maybe get a match between John Tenta and Savio Vega? Get Savio Vega a win? Oh, he's naturally stale. I didn't notice that.
Yeah, that's one of the reasons. Look, I joke about not giving a shit about Savio Vega, but he has negative status effects here.
Right, whereas John Tenta doesn't.
No. So... I want to get Kurt Angle on the card if we can.
He is.
Oh, yeah, that's right.
So is Eddie.
Yeah. So then, I would say a good opener, a good curtain jerker match between two lower mid-carders. Do we have any people who are jobbers left?
Proper jobbers? No, we haven't had jabronis in ages.
Oh, that's so nice.
Yeah, like week one.
No, it's so good. I think of these guys as the jobbers because they're the lowest.
Yeah.
But this could just be a good curtain jerker match.
Well, we've got two options. So I'm thinking, all right, we could do a match, maybe even getting some of our other tag teams in there. Scott Taylor, Brian Christopher, they're kind of sad because they haven't been in a match a lot. Mosh and Thrasher, they're facing heel, unless they're not going to take that because they feuded a while ago. Let's see how that goes.
Just, yeah, literally just have the Headbangers versus...
Yeah, Headbangers.
Yeah.
Too much at stake. So... Man. It's rough out here. Instead, we can do Scott Taylor, Brian Christopher... against Bradshaw, who's at 100% morale.
Bradshaw's in a great mood.
Who is
it? Test?
Test, I believe you're right. I believe. Brother Love, Brother Love, yeah. So we'll do that. Test's morale, it's okay. Better than these guys.
Yeah, they could use a win.
So there we go. We'll get them on the card, get them a win, and then do a segment, do a manager segment. For Paul Ellering.
Manage
talent.
Select talent. Mark.
Peer relay's fine. We need to build a mark.
Perfect.
Okay. next week we should probably do pay-per-view.
Yeah. That'll be the go-home show.
Well. Yeah. Yeah. Okay. Let's do it. Alright. Come on. Wow!
Yeah!
He's average now!
It worked!
Our boy!
Go, Mark Henry!
Yay! Okay.
This is just to get too much away.
Yeah, getting over here. It's okay. But, they like his gimmick. It's average. Good. Okay. Well, hey.
It worked out as far as it could.
What we wanted it to do.
This is still working hot super segment. Well. Hot segment. There's Funaki being polite champion, China being China at him.
This was fine. Okay, winning this match, we could have Chris Jericho stay dominant. Edge is hot. Eddie's hot.
I would say having Kurt win this is my call. But, like, because the point of these was to get the main feud on the card and then use it to boost someone else.
Yeah.
By having them win. So if we have Kurt win this one and then Owen win the other one.
Yeah, big night of surprises. It'll really make you want to pay attention to the pay-per-view. You never know what's going to happen.
And it proves these two guys, this being Kurt Angle and Owen Hart, who are realistically going to be in the King of the Ring tournament because they're not in other feuds right now.
Yeah.
It proves that they're main event contenders who can stick it out with the best of them. El Samurai's just over. Awesome.
Oh,
well, starting to get over.
Cool. Glad to hear.
All right.
Golden Age Grotesque is getting the win here.
They got the win last week. DX got the first win. So right now they're even. And Mark Merrill.
We talked about them getting the win because Mark.
And Mark and Goldust are both not in the best mood.
Yeah. I think you had it backwards. I think Golden Age got the first win.
Yeah, I might have had it backwards.
Cool. 4 stars. Nothing crazy. No one's dead.
Only went up by one.
No, but that's all right. They're over 100.
Yeah, they started out at 117.
Bigville Box. I mean, this is Homewreckers Inc.
Yeah, this is their slime surprise.
Yeah, that's what they do.
Comedy gold. Comedy gold.
Fantastic. Nothing changed. Oh, slime surprise leveled up.
Yeah, nice.
Okay, and this is going on. Oh, and Hart. How is anybody got bad morale?
No.
Dan's a little grumpy, but whatever.
Dan will fucking live. He's gonna be champion until next WrestleMania.
There we go. Look at that beauty. Nothing crazy happened. Nothing crazy happened there. Cool.
That was a good main event.
And 68 points, 4.5 stars.
Putting on great show.
Yeah, we are.
Putting on great wrestling, ladies and gentlemen. We went up 50,000 fans.
That's beautiful.
We're almost 10 times as much as our next highest competitor in terms of viewership.
All right, one show to King of the Ring. No, 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 no.
Fuck this. We're not doing a show. Go watch King of the Ring. first thing, pay-per-view hype.
Production.
Event package.
Did I skip it?
No, I'm just saying it because I don't know where it is.
There it is.
Boost event hype.
Boost.
There we go.
Okay.
Then,
let's check our stillness here. Yep, we still need
new challenger. That's the thing is, This is probably where we're going to have to blow this off.
I think we got such... We have a lot of options in the card. I think we just don't book new challenges this week.
Okay, yeah. We've got a lot of stuff to do.
We're good.
Give us time and freedom to be in the DX thing we did.
Sure, yeah. Without it being weird. Nothing else needs a
promo. So this is about what, storyline-wise, works best as a promo.
We usually do these guys as a promo.
And it works out super well.
It does. I'm here for the push-up promo.
Sounds great. Fuck it.
No, that our main event is not an event package.
We'll put more things on the card.
We'll fix it. This is difficult to book, so I'm going to say promo.
Promo, yeah.
What do we want? They don't... I guess feud hype is more important, right? Actually, it's before the pay-per-view, they should fight.
Yeah, storyline-wise.
Or is there a contract signing?
Oh, I don't think we've done a contract signing for these guys.
I don't think we have either.
And this is a great opportunity. Type the word contract.
I just don't want to touch my keyboard. Is that so ridiculous to you?
There we go. Yeah, that's the number. So.
All right, let's go book some more nonsense.
Let's have DX versus Triple V versus Golden Age be a promo this week.
Good call. Good call. Good call.
Factions.
Wonderful call. Well, hold on. I think we have to be singles.
No,
there's
a faction. Okay.
I know what I'm about, son.
All of the members of both. Oh, okay. Triple. Oh, we're doing Game Theory. Why would they agree to be on it? Oh, I love that.
Let's get HBK.
HB Shizzle.
And Mick Foley.
Yes! Yes! So, why are you a bunch of over-the-hill losers who are going to lose the DX?
You told me you were going to be nice to me.
I don't know why you believe that.
You gave me a coupon for a free steak sandwich.
Oh, that's not valid anywhere.
I drew that.
And then they bully Mick for a couple minutes, and then the rest of the Golden Age shows up, and then they fight.
Yeah. Good stuff. Okay.
Game Theory!
We're skipping China versus Sho Funaki. Jericho and Edge. Kane and Christian. We risk losing some stars from being a big clutch match, but I think we could do a big fat clutch match.
Fuck it. Do it.
Tag team. 3v3. So, Kane, he's a bad guy. Chris Jericho, what a dickhead. And everybody's favorite asshole, Eddie Guerrero.
Versus.
Edge is neutral, and he's against Chris Jericho.
Christian,
right. Right, of course, he'd be tagging with Christian. That makes perfect sense. And get Kurt Angle in there.
Okay,
where
sure.
Where did he go? Is he a main eventer already? No. There he is.
That would be so hilarious.
Oh my god, look at our boy.
What?
He's looking at him.
Yeah!
He's more popular than Billy fucking Gunn.
Paul Ellering knows what he's about, son.
Yeah, go Paul. Oh, I'm so proud. Okay. All right. What other feuds do we have going on here? We've got... Skipping that. Oh my god, is that it?
Yeah, dude. Big clutch matches really help.
El Samurai and...
The very important feud!
Yes, the very important feud.
That can just be a promo or a match. Either one. They were doing the best of series.
Yeah. Did they do a promo last week, I think?
I don't think so. I think we've just been having them do the best of series.
Alright. Again, it's gonna hurt our stars.
Big clutch match?
Draw. That's why they have to settle at the pay-per-view!
That's a good go-home! It'll hurt our stars, but let's do it.
Whatever. Fuck it. Who cares? Okay. No, not for the title. Alright.
Because currently they're even.
Yeah.
And then this would be the decider, so then they decided the pay-per-view for the titles.
Okay. So, that leaves us with three things we can do to build up some lower card dudes. Maybe get a big person, like a Stone Cold. Who does the game want Stone Cold to fight?
Shawn Michaels.
No, don't
always
fight Shawn Michaels. God damn.
Fight forever!
Yeah. Well, I mean, soon. It's about time to reignite that feud. Boy, howdy. Oh, how's Mark's morale? 51? I was gonna say he could fight Billy, but Billy's not doing that great either. Good old Mark Henry. Look at him.
He can fight X-Pac. Mark Merrick could beat up X-Pac.
Yeah, Mark Merrick can beat up X-Pac. Yeah, X-Pac's got great morale. All right, Mark and X-Pac. There's a match for
him. The thing about Mark is sometimes winning matches doesn't do anything to his morale.
No.
He's got that thing. Yeah. And that's end of the line on the thing twice.
Yeah, maybe it'll build up the feud even more.
Yeah.
I want to get Billy Gunn to win for reasons that I don't think I need to say out loud.
Then have him beat someone up.
He's a heel. Gangrel's still hot?
Gangrel's still hot.
Yeah, let's use Gangrel's heat to our advantage.
That's... why did that count? Oh, it's the Brood.
It's the Brood.
Duh.
Alright, then we've got one thing left.
Billy Gunn could beat Goldust and have End of the Line be on the card 3 times.
I mean... okay.
Because then that's one win for GOG, one win for DX, and then they have the and then they have game theory about it. Make it a match breakdown.
Oh yeah, that's why.
With Triple H as the neutral moderator, Shawn Michaels and Mick Foley break down the matches of their you know teammates, like a Sports Center thing.
Yeah.
But like Triple H is clearly not neutral because he is a shithead.
Right. I have met Triple H. Alright, so I think maybe just get some good guys in here.
With our last thing? Yeah just some main eventers, some people
Stone
who are cool.
Cold, Owen Hart, Ken Shamrock.
That's good.
Yeah, it's Triple Threat. Cool. Okay.
These guys exist, remember.
Don't forget. They're probably in the King of the Ring. Alright, cool. Ready?
Yeah.
Play. Okay, so Mark Merrill's getting a win. Nice, it was a match. Gotta hype that event. They like that slightly more than the match. Billy Gunn getting a win on Goldust. What the fuck? What is that? Nice. Oh, he's happy. That's really all I was looking for.
That's what you were wanting. Neither of those helped the feud, but I like the storytelling.
The Aranese are gonna win this push-up contest.
Yeah, they're clearly tougher and better.
Yeah.
That sort of thing.
Fantastic. This is ending in a draw. Add finish.
Draw.
Time limit draw?
It's expensive, but let's do it.
Okay.
We got money.
We lose only like a little bit of a star. It adds some staleness, but this feud's not winning forever, so no title change. All right.
Yeah, do it. Fuck it.
I don't know what that means. Why would it?
Select the challengers.
Okay. Wow, good match. Not bad. And they both got...
yeah.
Over for it.
Yeah, the game really doesn't like that stuff. And makes you pay money for it, which is the hilarious part.
Yeah. Well, they're creative points. So, I mean... Stone Cold's fine. Owen's fine. Ken Shamrock is... his morale is amazing.
I mean, we're pushing Ken Shamrock to the moon. Of course his morale is amazing.
Yeah, you know, he's almost going to tip over and be worth the time. So maybe he gets the win here. What do you think?
I'm fine with it.
All right. 26, beautiful.
And he's over.
Yeah, he's starting to go. Fantastic. That's what we wanted. Okay. And here we go, the contract signing. The Rock needs to look good here, I think.
Oh, yeah, because he's losing, so.
Look at that. Oh, yeah. Oh, hot segment. Beautiful. And then this big nonsense. The champions won last time.
So the challengers win this time?
Yeah, I think so.
Going into the pay-per-view. Because I don't know that any of those titles are actually changing hands.
Well, there's only the one title.
Well, yeah. But...
alright. Blam. Work to strengths. Good match. Nothing really crazy about it.
Okay.
57 points. Slightly worse than the last show, but whatever. Ooh, ECW got 5,000 fans.
Yeah.
Nice, good for
them. Dude, ECW is basically on equal footing with these other three fans. Like, they're all about the same level of pop.
Yeah, we're WWE, and then they're the rest. okay. So this is the King of the Ring show, right?
Yeah. So let's do the current tournament. Let's book that first. Tournament. There's a tournament button.
Right.
Yeah, that's exactly what we wanted. So select tournament, King of the Ring, elimination, and then we hold a certain level at the event. If you just wanted to hold the finals or the semifinals at the event.
We're doing a match contract with King of the Ring again?
Yeah.
Okay.
Last year it was like
SummerSlam, I think.
SummerSlam, or we might have done it like at the end of the year. But SummerSlam is the secondary WrestleMania.
Yeah. Survivor Series wouldn't be bad, but that's a long build.
Yeah, I would say SummerSlam's smarter. Do we want to...
No, I think we want to choose.
We want to choose.
So...
All right, so first up, scroll back up. Are we holding the semifinals at the event? So that's three matches on the card?
I think let's just get the finals, right? That way there's less... No, let's do semifinals. Let's do semifinals.
We always have space left on a pay-per-view card.
Yeah, we do. So let's get some guys in there.
This is someone who is getting a title match if they win.
Right, but like there are also people who need to be seeded out early.
Yeah, so...
I kind of see what you're saying, and let's do our higher card guys that aren't doing something else.
Which, like
Stone Cold.
Yeah, Stone Cold, but the members of DX are doing something.
Yes, they are. So that would be also the Patriot.
Yeah, the Patriot.
Owen.
Ten. And then scroll down, Eddie.
Yeah, Eddie.
Luna.
Luna's.
Not Farouk. Put Farouk in there.
Kurt Angle.
Sure. He's not gonna win. Yeah. Sure. Gangrel's not up to anything.
He's also like
over.
Yeah. All right. Yeah.
Again, he's not gonna win, but like he's not doing anything.
What are we at? Nine. All right, cool. Bradshaw, John Tenta, Test, Pierre Roulet,
Savio Vega.
They're stale though.
Yeah, it's true.
These guys here, what is he?
Just not over.
Man, just not over. Get the pig in there. What does that put us at? 14. So we need two more.
So if there are people who are in busy stuff like Sean or Goldust or The Rock's the current title contenders, not him. Or Mick Foley. Someone who's in like the big stable feud that we want to be, who's gonna be the obvious winner. If we were setting up for DX to lose, basically, if we know who we want to lose the eventual destruction feud, having someone from that faction be the winner gives them a really nice built-in thing to do once that feud's over.
The destroyed faction?
Yeah.
But we'd have to decide that now.
Right.
Do we want to?
I don't know that we want to.
DX works really well together. Do we really want to split them up in general?
I would be more amenable to splitting up the Golden Age.
Yeah, same. Because they were only really put together in the first place for...
Vince told us to reasons.
Yeah, Vince told us to. Alright, so...
If we have people we can put on...
You know what, though? Hmm. You say that, and I'm with you, and I understand where you're at, but would it not behoove us more to put over somebody lower?
This is a great way to slingshot somebody up the card, yeah.
Yeah.
Like...
I'm just going to throw Kane and Christian in this.
Okay, sure.
And...
Actually, we've been building a lot of non-title feuds. We could just stuff them all in this.
Well, I mean, we're at 16.
So, okay.
Create bracket. Do you want to just leave it random?
Oh, I don't care about that. Sure.
Okay. So, create tournament.
Yep.
All right. Great. Let's go. Play, right?
Yeah, this is the weekly show, so hit play.
Yeah, one show to King of the Ring play.
Yes.
All right. Stone Cold versus Phineas I. Godwin.
Stone Cold's going to win that match.
Are you sure? He's Stone Cold, work rate.
Stone Cold is going to win that match.
Okay.
Yeah, no. I know, guys. This is a tournament builder.
Mark Henry was Kurt Angle. Oh, I'm sorry, Mark Henry. It would have been nice for you to win this match, but it's Kurt Angle.
Kurt Angle's hot ticket for one of the people to win the tournament.
Yeah. John Tenta versus Kane. Kane is crazy over, but John Tenta didn't mind doing the job, so that's all right.
John Tenta versus Kane, by the way, great match.
Yeah, I'd like to watch that. In their prime, of course. Bradshaw versus Ken Shamrock. We've been pushing Shamrock.
Ken, we've been pushing Ken.
Yeah, no reason to put Bradshaw over. Eddie Guerrero versus Christian.
I feel like Eddie's the smarter call here.
I think so, too. I like how it's slowly building up. Owen versus Justin. Wow!
Oh, it's so good.
Put on a good match. Farouk versus Gangrel. This one's actually considerable.
Yeah. It's basically a matter of, do you trust Gangrel to remain over?
No.
Then guess what? That's your pick.
There we go. Was not a great match, but that's fine. It was okay. Patriot versus Pierre Lay. Let's get the people, the American people, a big victory.
Yes! Over the French Canadians.
Kurt Angle versus Stone Cold Steve Austin.
So, here's where we have to pick. Do we want to give this contract to someone like Stone Cold, who's already over, or use it to build up new talent? Because if we want to use it to build up new talent, this is the round when we start having main eventers lose.
Yeah, I feel like the main eventers can float into a title scene for no reason, literally.
So, Kurt Angle wins this. Kurt Angle beat Stone Cold Steve Austin to move on.
Okay, Ken Shamrock versus Kane. We've been pumping Shamrock. Kane's morale is kind of low, though, but he is going over Christian, right? Or no, wait.
The ultimate plan, I think, was to have him,
dominate the feud. Yeah,
so, up to you. I don't think either of these, they're both main eventers already, so neither of them's going to win the tournament, so it's about this match.
Yeah, I'm just going to simulate.
Okay.
See what happens. Roll the dice. Kane wins.
Okay, that makes sense.
Owen Hart versus Eddie Guerrero. Good lord, what a match. Eddie's morale kind of sucks. Owen's doing great, though. Let's get Eddie up there, man.
Yeah.
Yeah, you bet your ass it was a good match. All right, Patriot versus Patriot. Farouk, I'm not putting you in the title scene, my brother.
And that's All right,
that's it. Cool, it was fine.
Free extra 30 shirt, creative man. Points.
All right, so, to the book. Wow, Patriot versus Eddie Guerrero, Kane versus Kurt Angle. Those are some solid...
And they happen to just book regular good matches.
Those are some solid
with
matches.
With good psychology. Yeah. Thanks, game.
Yeah, I like that a lot. Okay, let's blow this off. You wanted China to take the title from this one?
Has Funaki been champion long enough?
I think I might have to unbook it.
Yeah, unbook it. This is the kind of thing you have to check first.
Balit. So, Sho Funaki has been champion for exactly 3 months.
So he could.
We could.
That's up to you. China's going to be busy with the DX versus...
Yeah, I think China can go, I think Funaki can stay.
Because China's going to be busy now.
And she's already higher on the card than him, which is not the point of our title. I think our next feud should be who takes the title.
Smart.
Okay. We'll put those matches early in the night so they can rest up.
Yeah.
The King of the Ring. Okay. And then we have Jericho and Edge, which is still going strong.
It's kind of high staleness, and it's not likely to get more.
That is true.
And it's been a couple months.
Oh, so, no, we wanted to blow this off in a promo.
So, Jericho wins this, Edge gets the blow off next week.
Promo on Monday, right, okay.
Where he, like, beats up Chris Jericho and moves on.
Whatever we end up going with the promo. Maybe he respects him, Edge is neutral.
Yeah.
He's like, I like your moxie.
He beat him twice, so he just goes, all right, you got me. But, like, it makes him look good.
Yeah.
Like, magnanimous.
Okay. Rock versus Dan, I mean, that's our main event.
Do we want... That one's probably going to be blowing off here, because it's pretty high staleness,
yes.
Right? So, do we want to add a thing to that?
Like a stipulation?
Yeah, do we
want... Yeah, I was making a suggest that. Add a gimmick. What do we got? Brawl for All?
No, fuck you. We're not doing that. Submission match would work.
I Quit would be good, too. Oh, if it's a submission match, maybe we can get that five-star.
Yeah, these guys are great talents.
Yeah, they're great. Let's do it.
Just do them. Do a submission match. Fuck it.
Low risk.
Low risk,
and it's Dan Severn talking about his MMA background. I'm gonna tap you out, kind of thing.
Yeah.
Okay. That's not a real feud. Tag team. Prove yourself. I think this is hit end of the line. You think?
If we just do promos, we have another match month. But I mean, we could also just blow this off and have the Aaron Ace take the title off the Hardys next month.
We could. Hardys just got the title though.
True.
So let's keep this running.
It's at the point where it's already 200. It's not going to get more staleness. So if we do this, it's just a month of promos.
Which is all what we do with them anyway.
Then I have no reason not to. This could be a promo too, for all I give a shit.
It could be, and we'll consider that. So let's do end of the line first. Sure, whatever configuration you come up with, I don't care. Dog has weekly sloth, right?
Yeah, Dog and Triple H both have weekly sloth. This is a great time for them. It's not weekly.
Sure, but HBK could be on the card.
True.
Oh, this is 2-on-2. Hold on, that's the problem. 3v3, and it's not going to show it there. So let's get Shawn Michaels, let's get Triple H, and let's get the Road Dog, right?
Yeah.
Weekly sloth, good.
Versus, you got to pick the other team.
Yeah.
There, they're just in the ring, patting each other on the back, very happy.
Do you ever just realize you're a fucking idiot?
I think ultimately, this is a great way of starting the story of DX being the ones who win, because at the end of the day, they just have more members.
Yeah, yeah.
And Vader's hurt, so he can't...
So I'm thinking what happens here is Golden Age goes over, next month we blow this off, they lose. And they're the stable that splits.
Yeah, because they beat these guys, but the next month, I wonder if the game will let us book like a handicap match where it's just DX versus the Age of Grotesque.
Maybe. I'll have to...
We'll check.
Look around. Yeah.
But yeah, we're not blowing this off, so...
No, that's fine.
Them winning here. So.
Edge and Jericho are blowing off, right? No, not yet, because of the promo. Okay, I just want to make sure all our blow-offs were in place.
And that's all our feuds, yeah?
Home record... Oh, this.
Very important feud.
Very important feud.
We got space for that in the card.
I gotta book that. It's a tag title shot. What are you doing? There we go.
And the Hardy Boys are going to win this.
Yeah, I think that was...
It's got plenty of staleness, so we could go another month with that.
Yeah, Hardy Boys.
And we're going another month with the Hardy Boys next contenders anyway.
Yeah.
So, there you go.
All right. Then, yes, we need to do a promo... We only get two promos, though, right?
Three.
We get three?
Okay. It's three.
Then I know exactly what we're doing. First things first, we'll do this. We'll get something and we'll build
fight.
Something. Yeah, just fight. Let's just make this... Let's make our pay-per-view good. There we go. We will do...
Tonk versus...
They really want him to feud.
I don't want them to feud. It's funnier if they're not in a feud. So, unlikely partners?
Sure. That's good. Yeah.
Yeah. Great.
So that'll push our fight up the card a bit there. Unlikely partners can go there. Okay. And then, just promos. Where's my... Oh, production. Here we go.
Main event hype.
Yeah, main event hype.
All right. Now, do the main event hype. This is the King of the Ring. Should the King of the Ring main event be the main event?
For the Royal Rumble, yes. For King of the Ring,
I don't know.
I don't think so.
I asked. I didn't have an opinion.
Plus,
we
got a gimmick on this one.
Yeah, okay. Let's do it.
Okay.
That's the show. That's the show, baby.
I don't think there was anything else we needed to put on here.
No, there wasn't.
No. Okay. And everything that's blowing off is blowing off, right?
Yep.
Yeah, because these guys are still going to go.
And then we're doing one more segment with Edge versus Chris Jericho where Edge goes over, but doesn't end up with the title.
Right. All right. Play. Woofage. All right. Predictions. Kurt Angle versus Kane. Predicted Kane wins. Did we do Kane versus Christian?
No, they're both in the tournament.
They're both in the tournament. Okay. We can blow that off. on the show as well.
Yeah, it doesn't need to be. It's just a personal feud.
Yeah.
It was a great way to build into the tournament.
Yes. Patriot versus Eddie. Prediction: the Patriot wins. Kane versus the Patriot. I don't know about that, man. What about Eddie Guerrero versus Kurt Angle? Sho Funaki. They say China's going to win the title. She's a little too big for that, I think.
And also, like, she's going to be busy.
Yeah, and Funaki's getting big, so he needs to drop it. Hardy Boys, they think El Samurai and Jushin Thunder Liger win the titles.
No, sorry.
No, not this time. Jericho retains, correct. Golden Age of Grotesque win.
Yeah, that's...
And The Rock wins the title.
No, and that won't be what happens here. So, main event hype.
Let's hype that main event.
Very effective, and also good grinding for that package. Yeah,
and Carl got some experience. That's what we love. We love you, Carl.
You like to see it. You like to see it. Kurt Angle wins this.
Most definitely. Kurt Angle. Bam, everybody.
Kane's was going to happen eventually.
Yeah. Maybe we can build him back up if he beats Christian.
He lost to two people. He lost to someone two spaces down on the card.
Yeah, that's true. but that's okay.
Eddie.
Yes, Eddie. Victorious. Good God, that's great. Eddie.
Same thing.
Nice. Not as good of a match, interestingly. Sho Funaki retains his title.
One of the matches had the Patriot in it.
Who is ridiculously over in our Fed.
That's true.
Funaki keeps his title feud over.
Good feud for the European Championship.
Not that it needs it, but yes. Wow, what a good feud in general.
Yeah.
Nice.
They put on a good show.
This shit happens again.
They beat...
It's nearly a 5-star fucking segment.
These boys, oh, their limited appearances are getting, we're getting so much out of them.
I love them.
It's much funnier if they're not in the feud.
Yeah,
the thing.
Yeah. Hardy Boys are winning this one. They won the best of five for their titles.
Yep.
It's okay.
And it's not not over yet.
Oh man, that feud became hot the second we ended it. Oh well.
Yeah, well.
Go figure. Jeff Hardy's work rate got to level 3. Holy shit.
That's one of the things we wanted, so good.
This segment happens.
And, of course, it was perfect. Nice. All, nice. Just exactly as perfect as King and fucking Tonk.
Jericho retains the title here.
Yes.
Okay, Jericho. Nice. Very good match.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Oh, Jeff Hardy's gimmick got over.
Yeah, it did.
Intercontinental Championship got some boost.
We're in gold now. That's good. That's what you want.
Yep.
All the numbers are green so far. Okay, Golden Age of Grotesque is winning here because they're the ones disbanding.
Yeah, and where this is going another month, mm-hmm. So...
Fantastic. So nobody lost out on that.
Mark Mero got over. Mm-hmm.
Mick Foley's work rate increased to level 3 as well. Mick Foley is the face of the company. Well, a face of the company. It's fucking great.
What a great reason to break them up.
Jesus Christ, yeah. All right, Eddie Guerrero versus Kurt Angle.
Now, this is the hard call. Between Eddie Guerrero and Kurt Angle, who is a better... face Kurt Angle, heel Eddie Guerrero. Who is a better challenger for Dan Severn? Because that's who's probably going to be the champion unless we make a weird audible. But
I would rather, like, in a month or two, give Eddie the IC than have him lose to Dan Severn.
Whereas, this is kind of strapping an absolute rocket to Kurt Angle. He shows up, wins, does nothing but win matches.
He basically pulls a Dan Severn, and then Dan goes,
"But he's faced."
No!
But he's faced Dan Severn. He shows up out of nowhere, does nothing but beat people. I don't think he's lost a match.
I'm not sure he has either.
So, yeah, he's 5-0.
Yeah.
So he comes in, does nothing but beat people for a month, wins a guaranteed title shot, shows up, takes it, is face Dan Severn. Dan Severn, ha 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 ha, cute child, kill.
Beauty. King of the Ring contract, very shiny. Yep, he won King of the Ring and the contract. Cool. Getting prestige for that, prestige for our tournaments, nice. Oh, Golden Age of Grotesque got prestige. That's so sad. We're going to break him up. Oh, well. And here's this shit. Are you ready for The Rock to become Dan Severn?
I'm not ready for The Rock to become Dan Severn, just so we're clear.
The Rock got exactly 2.5 out of that.
Scroll up. Did we get a good enough? No, not quite.
Hot match. Oh man, beautiful. People tuned in to watch. Nobody died. Submission match increased. Great. Championship prestige. Great. This has just been, what a great.
This was a fucking A+ fire pay per view.
People are gonna remember King of the Ring 1999. 137 fucking creative points. Gorgeous. Amazing. Classic match of King of the Ring between Dan Severn and The Rock.
Yeah, they tore the house down.
Angle.
Yep.
That was great. Everything was great. It was good, great. Kane and Kurt matched the year contender. Jim Cornette got fired. Maybe Lita? Maybe Canyon? Definitely Kurt Hennig. Beautiful.
God, look at the difference in buy rates. We're stomping them into the earth.
It makes me sad for competition, but glad for the Fed. Okay, we have got, someone's sick. That sucks.
That happens.
Yeah, okay. So, skill increase, Jeff Hardy. Skill increase, Mick Foley.
Ron the Truth Killings! Hello, sir! You got comedy chops, I assume.
You better. Kurt Hennig has not even debuted, and he's over.
Yeah, that makes sense.
Beauty. Pantera, who is still in our indies, is good and good. Okay, that's nice. I don't know who that is. Oh, we finally got Ultimo Dragon. The fucking prophecy is fulfilled. Nice. Well, we can sign him, but...
Yeah.
Mark Mero lost morale, but whatever. He's over. Pedro's down with the flu. That sucks.
Pedro's out for a month.
That blows. Lita's here, though. And Paul Heyman's like, yeah, take Lita, who cares? And we have Kurt Angle. He's gonna get Kurt Angle. Chris Canyon. He's gonna give us his best.
All right.
Cool.
Let's do some wrap-up.
Yeah, let's go to... Man, that sucks, that illness.
I mean, so we can't rub somebody's back. Is that... That's the
Pedro
only
was doing other stuff now, though.
That's true.
Let's just fucking just go ahead and do this shit.
Give him whatever money he wants.
Yeah,
Go ahead. I want to give him more money than that. There you go. Let's see? No? All right. More. Mm-hmm. Yeah! Send him right up. We make a bunch of money.
Yeah, we do.
That's like two shows. Ultimo Dragon!
We got him, man. We got him. Everybody else is fine. They can stay where they are. We definitely don't need Marty Jannetty. But we should research somebody. Ooh, Greg the Hammer Valentine.
Then that's who we'll research. Scout him.
Scout that boy. Thank you, Kelly. Can Kelly scout more than one person at a time?
I don't think so.
Well, because... I'm just going to see. No, okay. Pedro was able to do multiple things at once, is why I asked.
You wanted to see if they could get Waylon Mercy?
No, Kevin Sullivan. I mean, Waylon Mercy, is he on here? Because he's also good. So, anyway, we got enough heel managers. Cool. We can't do any massaging. What about... Is there any transitioning we can do? Okay, Ron Killings.
Kurt Hennig.
Oh, he's on a training roster. My bad. Thank you. Prepare for call-up. Marilyn Carter is already working. Oh, no, that's still going on.
Okay, good. So, that's fine. How much longer is that going to take? Go check.
A month, I believe. Yeah.
1 month. All right. It's close.
Yeah. Well, that's good. We've got a lot of stuff to do there. So that's our people, and I'm not... Pedro's sick, so, you know, it is what it is. Okay. That's the show, man.
Yeah. All right. Wrestling.